Pop Warner's Super Bowl Rap Show is presented by Genie. Dazzling plays, incredible athletic efforts. It's the 60th Pop Warner Super Bowl. From ESPN, Wide World of Sports at the Walt Disney Resorts, what an incredible day one that we have seen. Welcome to the Pop Warner Rap Show, presented by Genie. I'm Tom James. So many great highlights to get to. We've got 16 games to cover from this unbelievable day. So many great players and incredible action. And let's take you right to the unlimited division. St. Pete against New Haven. In the second quarter, Zach Burrow bobbles the ball. And the only female Pop Warner player, Nalisha Washington, with the recovery. And Japhez Cubez runs it in for the touchdown. The conversion no good. It was 6-0 New Haven. And then later in the second quarter, Daryl Kelly III from St. Pete trying to answer back for the Silver Raiders, and he does just that, chugging along down the sidelines, 89 yards for the touchdown, and that gave St. Pete an 8-6 lead. And then to the air, Mikhail Sanders. He's in there for the touchdown. That stretched the St. Pete lead to 10. They were on top 16-6. On to the third quarter we go. The opening kickoff of the third. Daryl Kelly III. Here he goes again, this time running left, finds the seam, and turns on the Jets. He is gone. Second touchdown of the night, 22-6, the score at that point. In the third quarter, it was Herbert Wright's turn to pick it off. Wright, looking for yardage, gets across midfield before he is dragged down. And then in the fourth, Nicholas Caldwell, short yardage, and he crosses the plane in there for the touchdown. And your final score, St. Pete rolls over New Haven, 34-6 was the final. On to the red field we go. Lee's Summit against Apopka. The blue darts. The big fumble recovery by Shane Fredrickson. And then it's Mario Woods Jr. taking it in for the touchdown. And it was 6-0, Lee's Summit on top. On to the second quarter we go. Under 9:30 left to play. And an incredible catch by Jaboris McMath. Do the math. We were tied at 6 apiece. Later in the second quarter, Rylan Fien catches it for the touchdown, back and forth as Missouri took a 13-6 lead. And then Eric Wright the other way, 14-13 St. Pete in the third on a 4th-and-3. And St. Pete stuffs the team from Lee's Summit. And then Eric Wright would run it in for the touchdown to make it a 20-13 game. And then the bobbled handoff, the pitch, he never had possession of it. It's Marquise Bradford that comes up with the football, 28-13, your final. And St. Pete advances as Eric Wright runs it in one more time. Apopka is in to the semifinals. And then Gilbert Chandler and East Orange, the Jags, taking the kick in there for the touchdown. They led it 7-0 in the second quarter. Loxley Burke going left, sneaks in there for the touchdown. The kick was not made. That made it a 13-0 game. In the fourth, still, this time a 13-8 score. East Orange in front. Dominic Hall takes it in for the touchdown, and that put Gilbert Chandler on top. They would go on to stretch the lead and win it, 24-13, a comeback victory. and Greensboro and Brick City. Shaquan Loyal in there for the touchdown, makes it to the corner ahead of the would-be tacklers. It was 8-0 Lions. On to the third quarter, Amaj Platt. He is taking it left, breaking tackles. Everybody seemingly got a hand on Platt, but he broke free and was in there for the touchdown. That cut the lead to 8-7. And then Jaheim Brown, as they air it out, Brown catches it for the Ravens. Sneaks in there for the score. William McKenzie then running it in for another touchdown. And that score right now in the fourth quarter, Greensboro on top, 20-8 is the score. So fast and furious action is some of the best games happening in the night section. Here are the brackets in the unlimited division, the semifinals. St. Pete, the Silver Raiders, a rematch from a game earlier this year. They will take on the Blue Darts from Apopka, and Gilbert Chandler awaiting the winner of the Brick City Greensboro game. We're coming back with more great highlights as the Pop Warner Rap Show, presented by Genie, rolls on. Stay with us.
Disney Soccer Showcase is the ultimate place for top clubs and players to be seen by hundreds of top college coaches looking for great soccer talent. Rated the number one youth soccer tournament in the U.S. in a Soccer America survey, Disney Soccer Showcase gives athletes a chance to shine on one of the biggest and best stages set for youth soccer in the country, here at ESPN Wide World of Sports Complex. For more information, visit DisneySoccerShowcase.com.
A beautiful night at ESPN Wide World of Sports at the Walt Disney World Resort, site of the 60th Pop Warner Super Bowl. We welcome you back to the Pop Warner Rap Show, presented by Genie. I'm Tom James. We've seen the highlights from the Unlimiteds. Now let's take you to all the action from the Junior Pee-wees, and we will start on Championship Field in that great matchup between Southeast Dallas and East Bay. First play of the game, Dalen Hicks running right and running towards the end zone, breaking a tackle, and he will go all the way, 65 yards for the touchdown. Dallas leading it 7-0. And then East Bay, Javar Horton fumbles on the sack, and the Wolverines from Texas, Cordell Russell, recovers. And that would set up a big score. Dalen Hicks in there for the touchdown. The point after was no good, but Southeast Dallas rolling up 13-0. And then Keveon Williams receives the punt, starts to his left, slips for a moment, but finds the seam down the sidelines. How did he get out of that trouble? He did, and he finds his way to the end zone. And the Wolverines from South Dallas rolling into the fourth quarter, and they would put it away. Your final score, 25-0. Keveon Williams, another touchdown catch, and what a big game for him. The Redfield, the Macadenville Dolphins against the Ohio Panthers. First quarter, Arvell Reese off to the races. He is gone into the end zone for the touchdown, and the Panthers on top, 7-0. Later on in the first half, second quarter, this time they give it to Sean Williams, running right, cuts it back inside and into the end zone, and that made it a 14-0 game. Still not done in the first half. Williams again waiting on the football, hauls it in, eludes the would-be tackler, and goes in for the touchdown. The Panthers pitch the shutout 34-0. On the white field, Point Loma and Lenape Valley. And second quarter, Drake Cobb scores the touchdown. Point Loma on top 8-0. Still first half, this time Jackson Emerson with the reception and the score. Point Loma rolling up 16-0. Into the third quarter we go, and more of the same. the Panthers. Going deep, Jackson Emerson with the reception and the score, Point Loma. The winner in a shutout over Lenape Valley, 32-0. And finally from the blue field in Junior Pee-wee, the Titletown Titans and the Milford Eagles. Is Tyler Da Silva with the reception all the way down into the red zone. Brought down at the 13. That led to this. Jameer Glenn in for the touchdown. No extra point, but it was a 13-0 game at that point. Into the third quarter, 13-7 is the score. Joseph Gardner for Titletown. A long run. He's running out of gas, but he all finally makes it to the end zone, 19-7 at that point. And then Tyron Small with the big pick. The interception runs it all the way back. Watch him change hands with the football. He will find the end zone. And it was all Titletown all afternoon as they defeat Milford by a final score of 40-7. Incredible action from the Junior Pee-wees. Well, when we come back, all the action from the Pee-wee division. Of course, there is the brackets from the Junior Pee-wees, the semifinals, Southeast Dallas and Ohio. And that'll be followed by Point Loma and Titletown. Incredible, incredible bracket. Check out the Pee-wee division when we come back on the Pop Warner Rap Show presented by Genie.
I chose this path when I picked up a ball.
A rookie doesn't have to play like one.
He can't stop me.
This is my moment.
It's my time.
I never cared about the why or the how. Just the hard work, hustle with my eye in the ground. There's no looking back. The time is now.
Who do you root for?
Who do you collect?
I collect Panini NFL trading cards.
Pop Warner Rap Show presented by Genie rolls on. I'm Tom James. Now it's time to take a look at all the highlights from the Pee-wee division as the players start to get a little bit bigger and a little bit stronger. We'll start Championship Field, Fort Osage Indians and the Hyde Park Cowboys. And look at Larry Jones, the quarterback, keeping it and doing his thing down the sidelines and in there for the touchdown. Fort Osage taking the lead, 8-0. Moving on to the second quarter, it's Greg Minnie Jr. going to the air, and he's got that man again. Larry Jones just goes up and gets it. He is in for the touchdown, an incredible play. Jones would score again before the half, and it was 21-0. Then it was Roman Tillman for Fort Osage, the quarterback, keeping it. Two-point conversion was good. That forced the running clock. Fort Osage dominant today as they roll on. 29-6 was the final. On to the white field, Northeast against Washung Hills. And the Falcons looking to Malik Allen. They can't bring him down. He is gone in there for the score, 6-0 Falcons. And then Quinard Logan with the pick. Big interception. The Falcons were on top 14-8. Later in the second quarter, same possession. After the interception, Mark Evans on the reception takes it in for the touchdown, 22-16. And the Northwest Falcons rolled on, winning by 8, 30-22. Was the final. And on the blue field, the Redwood City 49ers and Monument Blizzard, Kyle Demas with the end around for the Blizzard, gets in the corner, and it's an 8-6 ball game. And then on to the second quarter, Malachi Hoft going right up the middle, the big guy rumbling into the end zone. It would be a 12-8 ball game. The team from California in front. They score again. Jamison Howard runs it in for the touchdown. 18-8, your score in the third quarter. Monument comes back. Nomura takes the handoff, runs it in for the score. Two-point conversion was good, but it was the 49ers that would come out on top 25-16. So here are your brackets. In the Pee Wee division, Fort Osage matching up against Wilmington, who got the bye today. And in the other semifinal, Northwest from Miami will take on the Redwood City 49ers from California. Coming up, all the highlights from junior varsity as the Pop Warner Rap Show rolls on, presented by Genie.
The ESPN Wide World of Sports Complex at the Walt Disney World Resort in Florida has emerged as the pinnacle of youth tournament travel, catering to the needs of the entire family. We offer a complete line of solution-oriented products and services to address the complex needs of teams on the road and the team parents who support them. To find out how to achieve vacation victory, visit ESPNWWOS.com.
And we welcome you back to our Genie Studios on a beautiful Saturday night. The Pop Warner Rap Show is presented by Genie. We've got one more set of highlights, and this is from the JV division. And from Championship Field, Hoffman Estates, the Redhawks from Chicagoland, they're going for a three-peat this year. Ryan Smith going 26 yards, and they take the lead, the Hawks do, 7-0. On to the second quarter, and a Hoffman Estates, the all ball up in the air, and Michael Diogia intercepts the tipped pass. Then the bad snap, Hoffman Estates goes over the punter's head, and North Raleigh recovers inside the five. They will take it in for the touchdown. Cyrus Rogers punching it in, and North Raleigh takes the lead 8-7. On to the third quarter we go. Ryan Smith doing it again. Nifty moves as he gets inside the five, finds the end zone. Made it a 13-8 game. Later on, fourth quarter, Hoffman Estates. Brian Smith with the pick and the run back. Hoffman Estates was on its way, keeping that three-peat dream alive. Michael Diogia runs it in. This time from 35 yards out, Hoffman Estates led it 19-8. They go on to win, the final score 25-16. To the Redfield, Warwick and East Orange, the junior Jags. Kamani Maitland, boy, he was in the backfield before the ball was even snapped, it seemed like, with the big sack from Maitland. And then East Orange, Sharif Bryan in there for the score. That made it 6-0. In favor of the Jags. Second quarter action, still a 6-0 game. Warwick coming back. Tijon Jeremy runs it in for the touchdown to tie it at 6 apiece. Later, second quarter, airing it out. Terrell Neals catches it, and he is gone. The team from New Jersey taking the lead 12-6. Second half, a little over 4 minutes left in the third quarter, and Tijon Jeremy catches the pass for East Warwick. They run it in for the extra point, and the team from Rhode Island with a 13-12 lead, a nail biter. Coming down to the end, Darius Fry scores the touchdown, and East Orange, the junior Jags, keep that undefeated season alive as they win it 18-13. To the Whitefield, Riviera Beach, the Chargers against Almaden from California. Xavier Scott, he had himself an afternoon. Takes the kick all the way for the touchdown, and the Chargers led it 8-0. But we weren't done watching Mr. Scott do his thing. There goes the X-Man right up the middle. Another touchdown, 16-6 at that point. Now it's 32-6 in favor of Riviera Beach on the kickoff. And there they go. The seam down the far sidelines, cutting it back inside. Derek Lee for the touchdown. Big day for Riviera Beach. The Chargers win it in a rout, 39-6. And from the Bluefield, the team from Hawaii, Hanapepe Colts and Oak Cliff Titans. And the Titans, DeCorian Polk, taking the handoff, and he is gone. Say goodbye to Mr. Polk in there for the touchdown. They missed the PAT. It was 13-0 Oak Cliff at that point. On to the fourth quarter. Mikayo Vanaman gets the handoff, taking it to the outside, cuts in and finds the end zone for the touchdown. 19-16 at that point. And the interception would seal the deal. And the Oak Cliff Titans go on to win it and advance to the semifinals. Your final score as he finds his way all the way to the end zone, 26-16. Congratulations to the Titans. They are moving on. As we take a look at the brackets in JV, Hoffman Estates, they will go head up against the East Orange Junior Jags. The other semi, Riviera Beach, that high-flying team from right here in the state of Florida, will take on Oak Cliff, the Titans from Texas. Incredible semifinal matchups. Can't wait for those games. The Genie top plays of the day are coming up next as the Pop Warner Rap Show, presented by Genie, rolls on.
Disney Soccer Showcase is the ultimate place for top clubs and players to be seen by hundreds of top college coaches looking for great soccer talent. Rated the number one youth soccer tournament in the U.S. in a Soccer America survey, Disney Soccer Showcase gives athletes a chance to shine on one of the biggest and best stages set for youth soccer in the country, here at ESPN Wide World of Sports Complex. For more information, visit DisneySoccerShowcase.com.
Welcome back to the 60th Pop Warner Super Bowl, ESPN Wide World of Sports on a beautiful Saturday night as we wrap up day one of the 60th Pop Warner Super Bowl. Here's the moment you've been waiting for, the Genie top plays of the day. Here we go, junior varsity, the Oak Cliff Titans, Sammy Palmer Jr. Everybody had a hand on him, but he broke all the tackles all over the place and gets in there. He's worn out, but scores the touchdown as Oak Cliff went on for the victory. In the Unlimiteds, St. Pete's, DeCoriel Herkson returning the kickoff. He assessed the situation, decided my best option is to go right, gentlemen, and he does. Turns on the Jets down the sidelines, 85 yards for the touchdown. And then from Junior Pee-wee, Titletown, the big pick six by Tyron Small. He cuts it across the field. Look at him change hands with the ball. Such a mature play from a young man, Mr. Small, and he is gone all the way in there for the touchdown. All right, number two out of the Pee-wees, Northwest, the Falcons over Watchung Hills. Malik Allen, he has all the right moves, pushes away the defenders. Down the sidelines, he goes 67 yards on the touchdown as Northwest went on to the victory. Okay, top play of the day from the Pee-wees, Fort Osage Indians. Larry Jones with two defenders all over him just goes up and gets it. This is my football, gentlemen, and I am headed to the end zone. Call Sports Center. That could be the play of the day. Well, it has been a heck of a day, and that is only Division II here at the 60th Pop Warner Super Bowl. We've got a whole nother day of 16 games coming up tomorrow in Division I. So let's show you our four games that we'll have live right here on ESPN3 and streaming live in the Watch ESPN app. Starts at 11 a.m. with Richmond Pirine Giants from Florida against the Aurora Gators, followed by Palmetto against the Harvey Colts at 1 o'clock. Then Junior Pee-wee, North Philadelphia, the Aztecs, taking on the Rams from West Bay, California, and the Gilroy Browns from out in Cali. They will take on the Patriots team from Illinois. That kickoff scheduled for 6 o'clock. Tell you what, my first day with the Pee-wees, the Junior Pee-wees, the Unlimited, the Varsity, Pop Warner Super Bowl has been an incredible experience on day one. Looking forward to day two. Well, we always take time out to remember here at ESPN our old friend Jim Valvano, and certainly a friend of ours, the V Foundation. We've all been affected by someone in cancer in our lives. One in two men, one in three women will develop cancer in their lifetimes. Just in 2016 alone, nearly 1.7 million new cancer cases diagnosed. And cancer is certainly the second most common cause of death in the United States. If you'd like to donate, log on to www.jimmyv.org or call 1-800-4-JIMMY-V to donate. And that's going to do it for us. The Pop Warner Rap Show presented by Genie. Day two of the Pop Warner Super Bowl is tomorrow. Sleep fast, folks.